to another episode of I Got Big Bowls. Pause.
Pause.
I got big bowls.
Brought to you by CrunchTimeMedia.net for all your photo, video needs, you know, studio, whatever, you know, we're here. We got that for you. We got Mr. Danny Digital behind the camera, so you already know. Hey, so once again, we're back. It's another episode, man. Episode 31. We're on the other side of 30, so, you know, I'm pretty crunk, pretty happy to be here. And we got some special guests in the house this week. Our big boss, Pauls. All right, so to my right, you know what I mean, ladies first, we got wonderful Miss Dia in the building.
Hey, thanks for having me. I'm so excited. Right. Like, I'm really excited.
Thank you for coming.
I can't cuss, I'm so sorry.
No, it's okay. You can do that. You're at home.
But thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Tell them your social media and everything, you know.
Okay, you can find me on Instagram at PrettyDopeDia. The website is PrettyDopeProductions.com. My Twitter is, it's not the same. It is just Miss Dia, M-S-D-I-A. But you can find it all those places. All
right. And to the right of her, we got the ear doctor in the building. What's up?
All right. I am the DJ on the show, ATL. We all on the show. And I'll be bringing the mixes, and we just have a real good show. So check it out. Ear Doctor, Facebook, we got Twitter, and then we got Instagram, The Ear Doctor. Check me out.
All right. And then to my left, last but not least, we got Hollywood Kid in the building.
Thank you for having me, good sir.
All right, tell them how they can get in contact, all that good stuff.
Yes, glad to be here. My name is Hollywood Kid. I am the mastermind behind Hollywood Kid Entertainment Group. Social media is ATL Hollywood Kid. Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all that.
All right, and as a collective, they got the show ATL. Mm-hmm. And when does it come on?
We're on every Wednesday. We do 10 a.m. until noon, and then midnight until 3. And it's on 89.3 FM. Yes, so, yes, FM.
100,000 watts.
True. 40-some years. No, but, but yes, and you can also listen online at WRFG.org or on TuneIn app.
Make sure you guys are tuning in. Check for that. You know what I mean? Every Wednesday, Big Bowls every Wednesday too. Make sure you're getting at us on all our social media at Big Bowls Pause and on the channel, you know, Crunch Time TV. We're in the building. So
I want the stereo.
Alright, you know.
Sorry.
They had promised her some cereal.
Right.
I've been trying not to drink beer all day.
Right. You know what I mean? So this week, you know, we got a special brand I picked up, you know what I mean? So we're going to get to it right now. Big Ball Pause. Let me get a little drum roll or something right quick. Let me see which one I'm going to
do. I'm so excited. I love cereal. Y'all have no idea.
What the? Girl Scout.
Oh, cereal? No, you know what?
I've never seen that.
Girl Scout cookie.
And it was, I love Girl Scouts, but those were my least favorite ones. Why even get some mowers? Tag along. Oh, no, there's some mowers.
Oh, yeah, there.
Oh, I'm so in heaven right now.
That's fine right here.
Hallelujah.
Y'all see this right here? I need a big bowl of balls of this. Right here, man.
Oh, it is going to be interesting. I'm going to try this.
So this week on Big Bowls, we got thin mints versus caramel crunch. It's kind of like the Samoas. If you know about it, these are the Samoa joints, but they call them the caramel crunch joints for the cereal version.
Okay. Good pick. There you go.
What y'all want to see first?
No.
We might as well get this out the way.
No, but see, what if it's nasty? He's going to leave a nasty taste.
No, that's why I'm saying if we get this out the way, then that'll
no,
be the
No, but
last
if it's nasty, the taste is going to mess this taste up.
But then we'll have this taste yeah, nasty. Well, yeah,
but then we can get some of that.
Thin mints first.
Oh.
I'm ready for thin mints.
I think we got two for 10 minutes and one. I think we got our money.
I can't believe. See these niggas.
Business.
Traitors. Traitors. Scandal.
As she would say, light skin powers activate.
On back to the house.
Oh,
can't set them out.
Right, picnic style on Big Bowl right
thank
now.
Thank you very much.
And as always, I got the premium spoon. Not the little cheap Jones. These the primos. You can set these at Thanksgiving.
Right.
Wedding spoons.
Right.
Yo, we got air holes.
Hey, I'm so excited.
For maximum spoonage, pause.
Can we ask you a question?
Sure.
What made you start doing this show? This is so awesome.
So that's what happened. You know, I had a cereal craving one day, and there was a lot of new cereals I've never seen before. And I was real big on reviews. And I couldn't really find a review to satisfy my craving. So, and I was looking for something to produce as well, something original.
So in the store, it came from?
The cereal aisle. We like trying potato chip styles, seeing what they go for a dry before we add the milk.
Cause I know back in the day, I was like, I used to eat Trix and Honeycomb. Trix was my drink.
Yeah,
Honeycomb.
Yeah.
Damn.
I kind of like that.
Damn, it's kind of hard.
Word.
The only one.
Word.
I
don't
want to eat too many.
Whoa. Save room.
Yo. I ain't had no supper. I might bang out a big bowl of both of these.
Oh, man, and you got the milk I could drink.
Mm.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah. I got to do my research, man.
For all this lactose and color black.
You know what I mean?
We just want to eat some cereal while y'all watch.
This is going to be like Cocoa Crisp.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, man. I don't even like chocolatey brown cereal.
Oh, wow. These made a complete left turn as soon as the milk hit them, though.
Yeah.
They were straight dry, but when the milk hit them, though, they didn't go the wrong way on 285 on that one. Hold up.
So it's like eating a York peppermint patty.
You know the little, what's the little green little candy?
Oh, yeah.
The little green, the one with the foil on it.
Yeah. That's what it tastes like. Exactly.
Maybe
they got that little layer of mint in it.
Yeah, I want to love to hate these, though. It's like, they kind of tasty, but I don't like the texture. They're really throwing me off. Like,
No, I think I'm with you. It's kind of got like this weird attraction. Like, I don't like it, but it pulls me back in a little bit.
Right. I keep waiting for it to get better.
It's not bad.
I'm giving it at my teeth. You know, some stuff I don't want. Like, I don't want to taste it too much. I'm just eating it over here.
Okay, not so we got a 0 to 5 bowl rating. Anything in between, half a bowl, whatever. How many bowls do you think you'll do a thin mint Girl Scout cookie cereal?
On a scale, I give it a 3.5.
Three and a half bowls out of five?
Okay.
That's smooth money. So how many bowls do you?
Okay. I actually like the texture of them. Like, I like that they kind of airy, but, you know, still crunchy and everything. I would probably do about, I'll do 1.5.
1.5?
Maybe 1.5 bowls of them.
How many bowls are?
Yeah, given that this is my least favorite kind of Girl Scout cookie, it's not really that bad. But yeah, if I'm counting how many bowls I'm eating, I'm probably only gonna go by here, maybe 1.5.
Oh, you talking about how many bowls?
You
bowls. You meant like straight in like, a zero to five.
I'm like, no, you ain't even eating the like,
one you get. I was like, I eat a half a bowl.
You eat a half?
Wait a minute.
Hold
on. You're
making
on your
bones.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm still eating them. I'm thinking I'll go two bowls. I'll probably get tired about halfway through the second bowl, but I'm going to finish it. I kind of want to finish these just because I'm down to the last, and I want to get to the milk bars. Because I'm just curious with this chocolate
minty.
I
don't like that.
That's probably good if I drink
the chocolatey.
Yeah, I'm curious what it's going to be.
I have to have icing. That's one thing. I love cereal, but like I can't really drink milk. Like I drain it and everything.
Me too.
Because I even almond milk, I just feel like a child.
Well, that's
I think about drinking some stuff that came out of a cow and it just wears my head out. Like,
I try to keep it in the refrigerator as long as I could.
I don't know. No problem. Did we get new milk?
New milk.
Oh, okay.
New bowls and everything. We got
big things. You might just save that premium spoon now.
Oh, yeah.
Rinse out your bowl.
You got the air
hole. I think after I try this, I do want to come back and eat a little more vent because I kept it in my teeth. I didn't really try to let it.
You have one taste.
Oh, man. Right now, Thin Mints is killing them.
I'm so scared.
Thin Mints is killing them right now. I like them.
Yeah,
I like them.
You like
them?
Yeah. I don't like that.
This looks like that cookie that that they make with the Sprite jar. That's what it's
right
here, cookie with the Sprite.
Right.
And then when it comes out, it looks like little wooden donuts.
Yeah. Yeah, Samoas. You know, girl's got cookies.
Just like the Thin Mints.
Right.
That's what they call. Wow. So what y'all like for y'all cereal? To soak in the milk for a while and then, like, you like to get it a little soft and then eat it? Or just hit it with right?
Balls. Yo. It's whatever flows your bowl around here. But certain cereal, I want a little bit soggier. Certain cereal, I want a little bit crunchier. So it just depends.
I like a lot of milk in my food, but I need some crunch with the cereal. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I drank. I can't. Like, I really wish I would have been introduced to like almond milk and stuff like that before learning a cow or having cow make milk first. Because it really freaked me out.
So you don't drink pig juice, huh?
But you know what's crazy? You turn it. Turn that mess into some ice cream and I forget all about it.
That's different.
It's different, but there's milk, like...
What this taste like, a fake Cinnamon Toast Crunch or something?
It's something. I don't know what it tastes like. It definitely don't taste like no Samoa, though. I want to change the name.
Okay, the other one is Sandman.
They must get the rights to Samoa.
They got the rights to Sandman.
They
said no.
They couldn't get the flavor.
I'm not going to mess this one up.
Yeah, they couldn't get the flavor. So you know what? We're going to send that batch out and call it this. We'll get it right next year. Next season.
This tastes like donuts dipped in coffee.
But yo, earlier you was mentioning some of your favorite all time. What's some of your all time favorite cereals coming up?
Man.
Go ahead.
The Smurfs.
Smurfs.
You remember
the
Smurfs?
I don't even know. Only in Detroit.
It wasn't Kellogg's.
No, it was big. Listen, it was so big that even when they, you know, they put out the movies recently, they brought the cereal back with them.
Yeah, I remember that.
Man, I was watching one of the episodes where y'all had the berry vanilla. Mm-hmm. How were those?
The organic one?
Yeah. Oh, they were nasty.
They're kind of like the Thin Mints. They're better without milk. Once the milk hit them, though, that was... Yeah, it was terrible.
Was he Smurf? It was just like a blueberry, you know, kind of flavor, man. Oh my God. Smurf cereal. If ever y'all get a chance to try, for real.
No. I don't know. What about you?
Mine was Fruity Pebbles. Even to this day. It's an old classic, but like,
they're doing a lot of flavor with Fruity Pebbles now, too.
Yeah, oh man, they got to do ice cream or something. Yeah, I seen them and went crazy.
Yeah, I got
sherbet. It's like sherbet Fruity Pebbles or something.
My problem with Fruity Pebbles is like,
they get soggy.
That's why you gotta go on with it. You gotta get a big bowl with
that's
some
like
milk
rice crispies.
You know what I do though? It gets soggy. Or and just
man,
get some soggy.
Right. When I pour my milk in it, I be like pouring and stirring at the same time.
You ain't got time to stir no Fruity Pebbles.
You gotta go in.
Yo, my they favorite got, was Tricks.
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 I used to like Tricks, but have you had Tricks lately?
Did they change the recipe?
Yeah, I think they changed the recipe. Are they really are for kids? Yeah, there's no shapes or anything. It's just balls.
Oh. Right, so cookie crisp. No, that's my other eating? One. Oh. Cookie crisp. My sister used to give them to me for Christmas too. Like my birthday.
They had
some wrap her up a couple boxes of cookie crisp.
My other one was and they don't make these no more. Well, they changed them. Waffle crisp. They turned them into like cinnamon.
Waffle crisp.
Yeah, waffle crisp.
I'm digging for that.
I think I'm gonna do it.
What else? I like Honey Nut Cheerios. I eat them to this day.
I'm going to go a little bit more on these Thin Mints.
I kind of put just a little in here. I'm going to see what they like today.
You got to pour your own poison out.
You don't believe in it?
I would have poured it, but
I'm going to go.
Did
we say we like them yet?
Nah, no, how many y'all was going to be your all-time fave, but how many bowls of the, what do we call it, Samoa Jones, Caramel Crunch?
Yeah,
they got a Samoa on the, they do got like a little Samoa aftertaste, though. Once they, kind of.
If you close your eyes,
if
tastes like Samoa.
If I would have never known that they were... Samoa,
you wouldn't have thought.
I would have never thought like, oh, that was Samoa.
So yeah, I think they taste all right, but yeah, given the fact that you expected to eat Samoas, I gotta knock them down on that. Like that's a little deceptive. I would go two. Mm. I would go with two on it. You know, yeah, this one tastes a little better for me.
I'm doing 1.5 of these.
1.5.
And I was like, well, I ain't got coffee. I got like cereal.
Right.
I would eat one bowl of this. Yeah.
It's really flavorful. I will say that. So the flavor alone, I'd probably go two boxes. I'd knock out two boxes. I mean, not two boxes.
Damn.
Two bowls.
I'm gonna knock out
two bowls. Easy.
Like a big box.
I like that both of them, they aren't too sweet. I mean, they're sweet, but they're not like too,
I agree with that
too sweet. Or the, yeah. Like they kind of feel like.
Because they look real like Sugar Shock, but they're not really that bad.
Right. Rest of this mixture bowl and get me another bowl, probably. Maybe. So, verdict is out, Girl Scout cookies. You know, a nice novelty item, maybe. You know, everybody's saying bowl and a half, maybe two bowls, half a bowl. You guys can try it, see if you like it. Let us know. Let us know what you want to see on the show, what you want to see reviewed. We're going to get it on. Pause. Hey, man, thanks to the show ATL for coming out. Hollywood, the ear doctor. See you guys next week. All right.
Can we tell them one more last time?
Go ahead, please.
So, yeah, so please tune in, y'all. 89.3 FM. It is an independent station. Been on air on the FM dial here in Atlanta for over 40 years, bringing, you know, great music. So we play, our show is primarily hip-hop and R&B, but we play everybody from some of your classic, your favorite folks, right, to, you know, some of the current artists and a lot of the independent artists.
Good artists.
Yeah. So if you're looking for some Kendrick and Cole and all that good stuff.
We got it. Absolutely.
Yeah. So please tune in. Wednesdays, 10 a.m. until noon, and then midnight until 3 in the morning. And, yeah, that's what's up. And then we're at Apache Cafe every first Saturday of the month. We host, like, an Apollo style joint. So it's for singers, rappers, for anybody. You get 3.5 minutes, come rock out, and you love it, cash.
Absolutely. Thank you. Guys in the city, make sure you guys are checking that out. Follow all the social media handles. We'll see you guys next week. Hey.
Crank that.
I got two bowls.